We are at a point of time in our lives where we have a live action Mysterio on the screen, on the big screen. Yo. With the whole costume and the helmet.
Fishball, baby.
Hey, MCU, you've ruined us. What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh, and thank you for joining us once again on the Good Bad Filmy.
And I'm Spiderman.
Yes, he is. What are you?
I'm Spidey Colors, baby.
Quentin, I see what you're doing there.
Nice. Hi, guys, I'm Shreyas, and we just got back from Far From Home.
Yeah.
Oh my god, big expectations.
A lot to talk about here, firstly, man.
Yeah, and yeah, I mean, a whole new take on Spider-Man. He's not in New York anymore.
Yeah.
And yeah, we've got some crazy ass, big ass monsters. We've got rocks, we've got air, we've got fire,
yeah.
We've got water, or elementals.
Elementals attacking everywhere.
Yeah.
And yeah, dude, firstly, this is very, very fresh, like you already said.
Yeah.
This is a completely new direction for Spider-Man, considering
right.
We've had so many Spider-Man stories already.
Yes. Yes.
This is the only superhero who's had most, you know, kind of reboots
yes.
and movies and stuff.
Right.
So yeah, this is a completely different take. This is a really fresh idea,
yeah.
a direction for them.
Right.
I had a good time with this, man.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's still in the MCU, so the world is still reeling from the sort of end of Endgame, so to say. And yeah, the whole world's missing Tony Stark and how Peter Parker sort of adjusting to all of that. So yeah, man, let's just dive into the goods.
First and foremost, like you can already see, this movie is again directed by John Watts, who was the director for the first one.
Yep.
And you can see this guy just getting comfortable, you know, in the Marvel universe.
Really?
Because before the first Spider-Man,
yeah.
he had done some very small indie movies.
Right, yeah, right. We mentioned that. Yeah. Right.
So if you've not checked out our review from for
Homecoming,
yeah, do check that out.
Yeah.
So I've already mentioned that he's done smaller movies before.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is the first time I see him comfortable, you know, helming big set pieces.
Okay.
A lot of action in this.
Yes.
Big CGI monsters.
Totally.
A lot happening. So
yeah.
you can see him getting comfortable with the entire thing.
Yeah.
And taking more risks.
Yeah.
Which I really enjoyed.
Okay.
I really liked how, you know, all the set pieces were, you know.
I'm kind of divided on that. We'll get to that later.
Maybe later. Yeah.
Yeah.
Again. And yeah, secondly, the movie does a really good job in showing Peter Parker and his struggles.
Yes. Yes. Totally. That is something I totally bought into thanks to Tom Holland. And yeah, I mean, despite him being anointed an Avenger now from Endgame and from Infinity War. Yeah, exactly. yeah, I think now that he still is having this sort of whole battle of, you know, sort of fighting world ending, you know,
right.
scenes versus being your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man and looking out for his school and his friends and stuff like that. So yeah, I really, really bought into that. You know, there's a little bit of blossoming romance going on and how, you know, he's so, so like torn between doing what he's supposed to do as Spider-Man versus living his life as Peter
Parker. This is the first time I think we've seen him kind of
yes.
divided like that,
right.
where he realizes I'm just a 15, 16 year old kid,
right.
and you can't expect me to save the world.
Yeah.
So yeah, and him being torn up between the responsibility and the power,
yeah, yeah.
and him living his own life.
Exactly.
So it's really nice to see that. It's really fresh.
Yep.
I also find the MJ and Spidey, the Peter Parker yeah. romance, budding romance, extremely cute. The awkwardness.
Yeah.
I really, for the first movie Homecoming, I didn't really buy into Michelle MJ
yeah. Yeah.
as much.
Yeah.
But now, yeah. So as we see her character grow I'm kind of buying into it, man.
I think it's a little bit, you know, the other way around for me, because in Homecoming I really bought into like Michelle and then the big reveal that she's MJ
right.
towards the end of it. Here, I like that they're doing this different thing where you can very clearly see she's slightly taller than, not slightly, like Zendaya is like 5'10", Tom Holland was like 5'8", 5'9", at max. So you can see some camera angle tricks where they look like they're like, you know, same height
yeah.
or whatever. But yeah, I like the fact that they're both of them awkward. It's very
yeah.
high school-y teen romance
exactly.
stuff going on. So yeah, so I appreciated that. But
it's fresh though.
Yeah, but somehow I'm just believing less and less into how Zendaya is playing MJ. Maybe they're doing it too different for me, but yeah, I'm, you know, game to see what happens later.
Yeah, and let's not be fooled. This movie is a high school, you know, romance and a high school road trip movie
right.
more than a superhero movie.
Correct.
It's disguised as a superhero movie and marketed as one, but
nice.
It's more like a high school movie.
Fair.
Than anything else.
I'm sold, yeah. You say that, I'm sold. But yeah, but what makes this, you know, that big on that scale and, you know, superhero stuff is Mysterio, man.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
oh my god, this guy is insane.
He's, Jake Gyllenhaal is right now one of my favorite actors working. So the fact that he's associated to something MCU related just had me, you know, hooked to
yeah.
this movie.
Yeah.
Because I was really hoping to see what he does and I'm super happy.
Yeah, man.
How it turned out.
Yeah, and this is a long time coming. Like, he was rumored to be, you know, stand-in for Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man 2.
Right, yeah.
yeah, so this is 2004, like 15 years ago.
Go on, finally got Spider-Man off his checklist.
Exactly. And yeah, he just like runs with the character.
Yeah.
He is such an enigmatic character. It is so cool to see the stuff that he can do.
And I really like the relationship between him and Peter as well. It's just a nice, warm, like a new mentor.
Exactly.
The way they're bouncing off of each other, it's really nice.
Yeah. To see like Peter Parker lose his father figure in Tony Stark, and you see other people trying to fill in, and he's still dealing with a lot of PTSD and stuff. So yeah, so all of that, very, very cool.
Absolutely. But I'm pretty sure there are some bads in this movie.
Oh, there are more than some bads.
So this guy has a lot to talk about, so yeah, let's get into the bads.
Yep. As good as this movie was, you know, visually and, you know, new characters and, you know, evolutions in a lot of, you know, stories and stuff.
Yeah,
I still think that, you know, coming from Homecoming, because you're always going to compare it to the first one, and I just like the way, you know, he's dealing with very similar stuff there. And I don't know, just the pacing somehow didn't work for me. Like, the first half was a little too long drawn out, and yes, there's a lot of build up, and you know, things just get really kick ass in the second half. But I don't know, like the action set pieces too. I mean, I appreciate the fact like how movies are almost like very similar to video games, and you know, it's almost like you're using the character, and you know, you do this kind of stuff, and etc. etc. Here, it's almost like in a video game where you see the cutscene, and then the cutscene stops, and then you're supposed to battle. I didn't get to see the battle. I just saw the cutscene and I'm like, oh, what happens now? Like, I wanted to see more. I wanted to see what more he can do. And he has such a cool suit, and all this suit is coming from Stark Tech. I wanted to see more of that. And they showed very similar stuff to what they showed in Homecoming. So that was, I mean, I didn't really buy into it. So
I kind of actually enjoyed that. I thought the set pieces were actually fun. They're engaging. They're a little bigger than what Spider-Man is generally used to, because
huge.
He's fighting elementals, huge as villains. So I enjoyed that fresh take.
Yeah.
It's very different from the other Spider-Man movies that we really got.
Yeah, that's true.
I think maybe that's why I kind of latched on to it.
Right. Yeah, I think so. And then, I mean, I don't know, it just comes down to the fact that, yeah, they did some decent humor, you know, in the previous movie as well, and they tried to go along with that and like take it a step up, and a lot of it I didn't buy. And you know, there some other people saying this as well, that we are very aware of how the pacing is not very progressive or linear, and it's almost like to distract the audience from it, they've like forced in some humor, like hasle na to, you know, bhul jana. So I don't know, man. I could see so clearly through it.
Some of the humor clearly does not land. It's kind of forcing a little of some of the scenes, some of the places.
Yeah.
I completely buy that. And they're trying to cover up some mistakes.
Yeah.
They just, you know, put humor there so that you just laugh it off.
Yeah.
And kind of point him over what's going on there.
Yeah.
So yeah, that they do that. And some of the characters, you know, like again Zendaya, I'm kind of buying into her. But the way the departure from the comics of Mary Jane and even Flash Thompson for that.
Exactly.
It's very, very different. So
exactly. So some people like the difference.
I'm not against it, but for me as a comic book fan, it's very just, different.
Right, exactly. And for me, the difference is too much. Like, Flash is supposed to be this big guy, bully. Yes, he has a heart, but here he's almost like a wuss.
He's a wimp.
Yeah, he's just like all the time Instagram living everything. Yeah. So I don't know, but maybe we'll wait for another movie and
probably this is how bullies are. Yeah, go to school, bro.
Fair enough. Millennials, bro. What can
let's,
you do?
Let's get into the filming.
Yep. So this is still very much post-Endgame, this is Marvel Phase 3 final movie, so you do see that very, very much, specifically Tony Stark, because the rest of the Avengers are not on Earth anymore, and you know, we've seen that in the trailers obviously. So yeah, I mean, not just how it's affecting the world, but how it's affecting Peter Parker, and you know, you can call it PTSD, you can call it him feeling, you know, guilty or lonely or whatever,
or
it is.
Or maybe bored down with all the responsibilities that are not just put on him, even though he's just a kid.
Right, like he just became an Avenger, now people are expecting him to like replace, you know, Iron Man, either because he was close to him or because he's as smart, etc.
Or he's part of an Avenger, he's part of the Avengers now.
Exactly. So just the whole MCU thing and the way they've included it, and the way, you know, Spider-Man features in this, and you know, how he's sort of discovering more of himself and how he's realizing that he's part of a bigger world now. I think that's done really, really well. And yeah, it's super different from the comics. You know, he makes his own suits, but he's got so much of help from Stark Tech still. So yeah, so there's a lot of, you know, that stuff going on. You know, Happy is still chilling around him. He's also hitting on his aunt. That's really cool. So that was really cool.
I think the movie does a good job of establishing how the snap both the
There's a nice explanation to that.
Nice exposition scene, and it didn't feel too exposition heavy.
Correct.
But it's kind of informative right at the beginning of the movie.
Right.
So it kind of just sets you in, you just know where you are post the snap.
Correct.
And it just fills you in with all the details and how the world is kind of reeling in with the Fireman and the entire
Yeah, and just like we spoke about Mysterio and, you know, Jake Gyllenhaal being like a total badass in the goods.
What a guy.
Yeah, just the way they've taken his character, the kind of stuff that he can do is insane.
Absolutely.
And Absolutely. And it almost, you know, makes sense, like how, you know, Flash says in one of the trailers that, oh, he's like Thor and Iron Man combined.
Combined, yeah.
Yeah, so this guy can do some really cool stuff. Yeah. So, yeah, really, you know, excited to have
Jake Gyllenhaal. How can you have someone like Jake Gyllenhaal and not be attracted to him? You know, as a presence, Jake Gyllenhaal is such a personality.
Yeah, he's just like living it out.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And he's enjoying himself with this role. You can see he's having such a good time with the role.
Exactly. And like, obviously, you know, Tom Holland and Peter Parker, we've seen him since Civil War. He's had his own movie. This is the second time. Nick Fury, you know, actively features. But when Jake Gyllenhaal's in the room with the same guy, he's like owning all of them, and like he just steps up.
He's having fun.
Yeah, he's pretty much in charge. Yeah, like he, you know, introducing himself to Peter. He's like, hi, you know, my name's Quentin.
Yeah.
And like Peter Parker's like, oh, so nice to meet you. Yeah, it's like, you're so cool, man. So yeah, so Jake Gyllenhaal, really freaking cool. Absolutely. So glad, you know, he's playing Mysterio.
And even the relationship between them, I really, really enjoyed it.
Totally, totally.
And as a whole movie in itself, I think the direction that these guys took, I was really happy with it, because I'm sick and tired of seeing Spider-Man just save this neighborhood again. Fighting over the same villains in the same city, in the same neighborhood.
Right.
So it's a very fresh change that these guys are just completely away from the city and the country. They're in a new place altogether.
Yeah, man, it's like a new continent, multi-city.
Yeah.
He's doing his Europe tour and he still can't have fun. Another thing that we were speaking about is that literally 90% of what you watch in the trailers is like the first 5 minutes.
First 5 minutes, and I am so happy for
that.
I'm so happy with that. Marvel is, you know, they've wisened up and they're doing all of this.
Right.
So they're not giving away too much now.
Yeah, and not just like, you know, showing like the first 5 minutes in the trailers. They're pretty much shooting stuff in the trailers that may or may not feature in the movie.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's not like, you know, they're giving too much away or they're leading you on. It's just that, dikha diya, dekh lena. You know, just buy your tickets and figure it out for yourself.
Learn something, DC.
Nice.
So let's just get in the rating, man.
I'm a little scared about this.
Are you?
Yeah.
Get into the rating. So all in all, I think I had a really good time in the theater with this movie. I am a big fan of Spider-Man. I really enjoy the kind of direction these guys are taking it into.
Yeah.
The way this movie wraps up, it just leaves you wanting more.
Yeah.
And you don't know where this movie is going to go. So I had a blast. I would definitely give this movie 2 thumbs up.
Okay.
Tom Holland, I would love to see you play Spider-Man till you're like 90 years old. So, 2 thumbs up for sure.
Fair. I mean, I'm kind of divided. Yes, I'll watch it again, and because obviously, you know, some of the stuff that you can see is just mind-blowing. Curiosity factor, 100%. I'm divided. I want to give it a thumbs up because I will end up watching it again. So yeah, it's worth the watch.
Oh, ouch. Marvel, you've ruined us comic book fans. we have such high expectations now. It's mad.
No, but honestly, like, I was actually afraid of the fact that how they've done, built up to Endgame last, you know, 11 years, 22 movies. They're going to have a tough time. Like, I believe this is a version of a peak, and the other characters are not, you know, main characters, and Spider-Man is the only one we've recognized for like so long, and there's a lot riding on this. So I'm sure this is going to get good reviews, it's going to make the money, but yeah, me personally, not entirely sold.
Let's see. So that wraps up our review of Spider-Man Far From Home.
Right.
Let us know what you guys thought in the comment section below.
Right.
The spoiler review is going to be out really soon as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, be back for that once you've seen the movie. Let's get into a discussion. Tell us what you guys like. Let me tell you what we like.
Yeah.
Like, share, subscribe as usual, guys. Be back for more.
Yeah, and don't hate on me, please.
Yeah, this is us signing off. Cheers.
See you. Thank you so much for watching Good Bad Filmy. If you want to, keep a check on us, follow what cool stuff we're doing. Instagram's right there. We're doing a bunch of videos, you can subscribe right there.
Please do.
And yeah, this is a geek alert, man. So we got a lot of stuff going on down below. You can check us out, you know, whatever we've been up to. And yeah, you know, stay in touch for more stuff, baby.
Be back for more.
Yo.